Yeah, he was a cranky old man. He'd been there 50 or 60 years. And he said, yeah, I have some jade, but I don't put it out. People steal it. I said, well, can you show it to me? And so he brought out a shoebox that had 60 jade carvings in it. And he said, if you want it, you have to take the whole box. I was very reluctant because I hadn't really looked at jade before. I said, I didn't know what all these things were. And I got him to agree that if I took it, I would show it to Myrna, and if she liked it, and we both liked it, I'd buy it, but otherwise I'd give it back. Anyway, he sent it off. It was at a time, for some reason, he mailed it to me in Ascona, because we were there for the summer, or the month, not the whole summer. And when we got it, we looked through the whole thing. There were really interesting carvings, but we didn't know anything. So naturally, we went to Dr. Rosenbaum, and we showed him the jade in the box, and he didn't know anything about jade either. So we went to Mr. Kohler, who had another type of antique shop with mostly Tibetan and other Asian things. And he couldn't tell me anything either. So we said, well, we'll go to the jeweler. The jeweler in Ascona, because he must know about jade. He didn't know anything. Well, by then, we were really wondering, what the hell do we have here? And so we decided to buy it and try to find out what we had. And eventually it turned out that there were jades, mostly Chinese, a couple of pre-Columbian. And they ranged from the Han Dynasty to the 19th century. And that was how we got involved in Chinese.